Welcome back. You're watching NewsX, and our top story at this hour is Rajnikanth and how some fringe groups down south are opposing his visit to Sri Lanka. Remember, Talaivar, as he's popularly known by his fans, superstar Rajnikanth had to participate in an event in Jaffna in Sri Lanka. He's supposed to hand over the keys of 150 homes built by the Gnanam Foundation on the 9th of April to displace Tamils in Jaffna. Now, fringe groups, multiple, have stated that Laika Productions, which is producing Rajnikanth's next movie, 2.0, is a Sri Lankan organization supposedly close to Mahinda Rajapakshe. And they have a grudge against Rajnikanth that he hasn't spoken out enough or vociferously enough about Tamil issues in the past as well, related to Sri Lanka and opposed to it as well. Let's take a look at reactions coming in, the kind of reactions we're getting on Rajnikanth's proposed visit to Sri Lanka. We'll come back to more inputs later.
There is no any personal agenda for me. I am very close friend to Mr. Rajnikanth. My contention is there are some motives behind it, particularly commercial motive and political motive. Mr. Rajnikanth, if he visits to Jaffna, definitely it will against to Tamils. He is indirectly supporting the idea of Sri Lankan government and Indian government.
In a democratic country, should be decided democratically as per the constitution, as per the freedom and liberty of individuals. And moreover, as an actor, so what should be done should be decided by him only. I don't want to say anything about that. But he is a good man. Whatever he does, I think he will not harm anybody, he will not disturb anybody.
All right, let's get in some more inputs here. My colleague Uday Pratap Singh joining us from the newsroom. Uday, what exactly is the genesis of the problem here? What exactly do the fringe groups want? What's their grudge against Rajnikanth?
Well, before I get to that, Athar, I just want to run our viewers through some, through these slides over here so they understand the sequence of events, really, what's really happened. Now, the row is basically over Talaivar's 2.0. It's being produced by Laika Productions, which, of course, is a Sri Lanka-based company. They're the main producers behind producing this robot 2.0. Let's draw up the next slide now, if we can. Which will, of course, tell you about more about the issue. Can we get to the next slide? Okay, we'll just get to that in just a bit. But, so this is being opposed by the fringe groups. Now, remember that Gnanam Foundation, which actually has constructed those 150 homes, which Rajnikanth is going to hand over the keys to, is also a part, Athar, of this Laika Productions company. That's something that's being opposed by these fringe groups, saying why should he go for a big launch for a company that, of course, is based in Sri Lanka. Now, a sequence of events also, remember, Robot 2.0 has, of course, been in the news because journalists were also attacked by the crew of the film just 24 hours ago because they were shooting the crew in the... Now, a sequence of events also, remember, Robot 2.0 has, of course, been in the news because journalists were also attacked by the crew of the film just 24 hours ago because they were shooting the crew in the day. After that, of course, Shankar had also apologized to the photojournalist fraternity. However, that's, of course, a different issue. But the basic answer to your question, which you asked me earlier, Athar, is the fringe groups have a problem with A, Rajnikanth going to Sri Lanka, and B, him inaugurating the homes which are part of Laika Productions, initiative, which, of course, is a Sri Lanka-based company. They're basically opposing him going to Sri Lanka in the first place. Remember, Rajnikanth has not visited Sri Lanka in the last 3 decades. He went there last in the 80s, and that's why, of course, Laika Productions has this grand plan of him going over there. It's all in the run-up to the film's release. Right now, of course, the shooting is on. But since Gnanam Foundation, of course, is linked to Laika Productions, it's all being done in a run-up to the grand release of Robot 2.0 to get the buzz going and to get, obviously, their lead star, Rajnikanth, to travel to Sri Lanka as well.
So there is a view that the fringe groups could be in it for that bitter publicity they get off, mileage really they get off Rajnikanth. He is after all a huge star And even if some groups have a grudge against him, they'd get the mileage they want. Of course, that's a theory at this point. They believe their cause is just and right. This is, of course, the trouble that Rajnikanth has run into, or his visit to Sri Lanka has run into. Let's take a look at some reactions and we'll move on after that.
I'm very happy to know about that. The Sri Lankan Tamils, they are suffered like anything. And anybody, any private agency and service organization, they give some support. And now I'm very happy to know about this also. That I'm very happy about it. And for that, Sri Rajnikanth is going there to hand over the keys. Good news. But I want to convey along with that, our Indian government has made very good effort. And some 46,000 have been promised, and already 40,000 houses have been already ready. This is my information.
Dalit Party VCK is opposed to Rajnikanth's visit to Jaffna in the month of April to take part in a program over there organized by Laika Productions. Rajnikanth will be visiting Sri Lanka for 3 days in the month of April as part of promotion for his movie Robo 2.0, produced by Laika Productions, a Sri Lankan-based company. VCK says that Rajnikanth has been a mute spectator on Sri Lankan issues in the past, and his visit now will send out wrong signals. Thirumavalavan, the chief of VCK, says he is requesting Rajnikanth to rethink his decision to not visit Sri Lanka. In Chennai, with video journalist Videsh, Lokpriya, NewsX.
Across to Lokpriya now, joining us on the phone line. Lokpriya, has Rajnikanth at all considered changing his itinerary after this, or is this fringe group too much of a fringe group, really, in that sense, to bother Rajnikanth and his entourage?
Well, at this point in time, there has been no change in his schedule. Rajnikanth will be on a 3-day visit to Sri Lanka to promote his movie Robo 2.0. Which is to be released in December. It is being produced by Laika Productions, a prominent Sri Lankan-based production company. He will be participating in various activities in the northern province. And the Tamil activists over here are up in arms against Rajnikanth's visit, stating that he should not be visiting Sri Lanka because, because Laika production is close to Mahinda Rajapakse, and asking him to reconsider his decision. But it is going to be very unlikely that Rajnikanth will change his plan. The event is scheduled on the 9th, 10th and 11th of April, where he will be visiting Jaffna and handing over keys to newly constructed homes for the Tamils over there who were displaced after the war. This war is funded by Nyanam Foundation, which is a foundation named after...
All right, Lokpriya, stay on. We're getting some more views here from BJP leader from Tamil Nadu, H. Raja, joining us. Mr. Raja, do you believe these fringe groups and their demands are really that exactly fringe group demands? They say he hasn't vociferously come out for Tamil issues earlier, and they believe him doing business with Mahinda Rajapakse controlled holding firm constitutes an affront, really, to the Tamil cause. What do you think is the genesis of this problem?
Mr. Rajnikanth is a celebrity from Tamil Nadu, and if he is attending any program for handing over of the houses to Tamils in Jaffna, I don't think anything wrong in it. And it doesn't mean that Rajnikanth is endorsing whatever has happened against Tamils in Sri Lanka.
So you believe this is a bit of a much ado about nothing sort of a situation, because they want to perhaps get that stardust rubbed off on them from Rajnikanth. They want to get some mileage out of it.
No, yeah, it always happens that by criticizing popular people, people want to get some mileage. But in this, the program per se, it is for handing over of houses to Tamils in Jaffna. And if a celebrity from Tamil Nadu like Rajnikanth is invited for the function, I don't see anything wrong. And the protest is unnecessary.
Would you ask these fringe groups, as we are calling them right now, to call off their protest?
They have to call off. That is because the houses are being handed over to Tamils only. So what is that? So it is better that such agitations are called off, and if it is not organized, I've been happy.
All right. H. Raja of the state BJP there saying this is a bit of a staged protest, really, because they want to get some mileage out of it. There is no real sort of point which they have, because after all, these 150 homes that Mr. Rajnikanth is going to give away the keys to will go to displaced Tamils in Jaffna. And they are the same people. And the point about Mahinda Rajapaksha's holding firm that is close to Laika Productions, that has bankrolled his next movie, 2.0, that could be written off as a coincidence. And after all, it is after all Tamils, displaced ones, that too, getting the benefit out of it. We'll try and get you some more on this. As far as the reactions from the Fringe group itself is concerned, I believe one of my colleagues earlier spoke to them. I believe it is Lokapriya. If you could just play that right now, just to give the perspective of what their charter of demands is at all. Once we get that ready, we'll play that for you. In fact, Rajnikanth is no stranger to controversies. He is a popular figure down south and across the country as well, and he has legions of fans, although notoriously apolitical ever since he decided to back one political party. Didn't really turn out that well in the 96 election for Rajnikanth and the person he was supporting. But since then has stayed away from endorsing anyone or being seen as too close to someone, although rumors, of course, are rife about him floating his own political party with the BJP's help there. But that's not the story right now. The story is fringe groups, Tamil groups, opposing Rajnikanth's visit to Sri Lanka. And the purpose of the visit is very clear. He will hand over keys of 150 houses that will go to displaced Tamils. So he's, after all, helping Tamils. And whether or not that's helping the Tamil cause, I don't see the difference here. Of course, fringe groups have a different rule. Can we play that soundbite right now to get an idea of what these fringe groups really are demanding? All right, we'll get that in just a bit. I believe in a couple of seconds I'll show you that, and we'll move on with more inputs on this story and many more. Rajnikanth, of course, hasn't said a word till now, and he is unlikely to. I believe we have that soundbite right now. Let's take a look. All right, we don't have it quite yet. Apologies for that. But we do have Suman Sri Raman on the phone line, and we spoke to him earlier about this as well. And we spoke to some other BJP leaders, Mr. Suman Sri Raman, and they seem to believe that mileage really is the cause for all of this. Because after all, whether or not he's forwarding the Tamil cause, he is helping out Tamils, and that should be what should be important here.
Man, whether he's doing it for a commercial reason or whether he's really helping, he has not really spoken very much about supporting the Tamil cause earlier, but that is not the point. The point is, I mean, he's going there to inaugurate some houses. It's a private visit, and the chief minister of the northern province and other dignitaries associated with the northern provincial government, which is a government run by the Tamils, are going to attend the function, is what we are hearing. So if that is the case, then there should be no problem, because if the government of the northern province is itself interested in supporting this event, then I don't see why people in Tamil Nadu should have problems with it.
All right, stay with us, Suman Sri Raman. Jayaprakash joining us as well right now. Jayaprakash, what's the latest on the demands by these fringe Tamil groups? And expectedly, Rajnikanth's camp hasn't really responded to this, because I believe at this point they don't consider this to be too much of an issue right now. It's just some group protesting against Rajnikanth. That's happened before. But what's their main cause right now?
Well, basically, they have been saying that there is a lot of conflicts surrounding the Tamil movement in Sri Lanka. This being the case, if Rajnikanth accepts this invitation and goes to Colombo to inaugurate and hand over the keys of these houses, of these 150 houses in Sri Lanka, that will be acknowledging the fact that the Tamil movement gets defeated in Sri Lanka. That is the reason why they have nothing personal against Rajnikanth, acknowledging the fact that the Tamil movement gets defeated in Sri Lanka. That is the reason why they have nothing personal against Rajnikanth. There's nothing, they wouldn't want to acknowledge what Rajnikanth does for Tamilians. But this will defeat the purpose of Tamilians in Sri Lanka. That is why they don't want him to go to Jaffna or inaugurate the function. So basically, they are against it. The fringe group are clearly saying that they are not against Rajnikanth. But
all right,
the very fact
get
that the government
just
wants to hijack
well. We need you for the other
government.
Stories as well. Thank you for that update, of course. That we understand by now what the problem seems to be as far as the charter demands by the Tamil groups are concerned. And Rajnikanth, of course, expectedly and perhaps even wisely not responding to this. This could, as hope by Rajnikanth, die its own natural death in the news cycle. We'll have to wait and watch whether that happens or not. The Sri Lankan government, of course, hasn't reacted either on this. It's just the Tamil groups who are coming out and protesting against Rajnikanth's proposed visit to Sri Lanka. Remember, that's happening on the 9th of April. It's quite a bit away, and the protests have already started. Thank you for joining us, Suman Sri Raman. Jay Prakash will join us in the next story as well. But in the meantime, we'll take a look at this. And these are some other stories. During the round.